Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to another Let's Revisit. A game from my past. I said I was going to play an Amiga game next time, but I forgot. I have not included any of the PC games. And this is one that I could possibly add in there, because it's not that long, although I never have finished it, so I'm not sure how long it is. But, as you can see, it's Demon's Forge. Written by people I've never heard of, Randy Walsh and Troy Worrell, but perhaps you've heard of the designer, F. Brian Fargo. Not sure what the F stands for. Maybe frickin' Brian Fargo. So the interesting thing about this is it's the same Brian Fargo, of course, that went on to Interplay and In Exile game companies. Well, this originally came out in 1981 for the Apple II something or other. One of the Apple computers. And was ported to the PC 6 years later. Now, this is a little behind the times, even for 87. All I know is, I don't know, I was in either Babbage's or Electronics Boutique. Possibly not even that. I could have been in Walden Books or Barnes & Noble or something like that. And I picked this up. I knew I wanted some more games. I had played King's Quest, Space Quest, games such as that. Hacker. I have some... I have a LP of Hacker. And I have an LP of the first three King's Quest games, however they are remakes by AGD Interactive. There was no sound in this game. I was a little disappointed on playing it. It's basically... it does have screenshots on the back, so I should have known better. But I was a teenager at the time, so I was drawn in by the hype of this game, Demon's Forge. You know, fighting your way out of, you know, this dungeon. And it's a text adventure. It's a interactive fiction game with graphics. So the interesting thing is that Brian Fargo actually, he, you know, created this game with the help of some of his friends. I don't know, I assumed that he came up with the story as well. Supposedly, from what I've seen, an article I've read, he, regarding his history, he only knew he was only an adequate programmer in BASIC. So he had his friend draw pictures, and had another friend draw up a subroutine in assembly for displaying said pictures. Well, he would trace over them on his tablet, I believe. So yeah, these are tracings of his friend's pictures with subroutines written by another friend to display the pictures, along with the text. And I guess he didn't write it either. I assume he had written it. Anyway, he would call different companies around the nation, the U.S., and say, "Hey, do you have the game Demon's Forge? Yeah, I saw an ad for it." And he took out one ad, which cost him like a sizable amount of money back then. "So I saw an ad in such and such. Do you have that game? Do you have Demon's Forge?" And of course they'd say no, and they said to try to get it for him, and he'd hang up the phone, and then they'd call him, his other phone, right in the same room, and he'd pick it up, and I guess he'd try to put on a different voice, and he'd get an order for Demon's Forge. Hilarious. Anyway, I'll stop talking. I have this on pause, actually. Instructions, yes. Yes. Okay. There are pictures shortly. There was no sound, so I assume after I play this, I'll try to find some sound to put in the background, some music. Anyway. "Death to him, your majesty. He killed four of your guards in a tavern brawl. The king stands peering down at your bruised and battered form. You meet his eyes, snarling in defiance, and trying to break free from the grip of heavy chains and manacles. The monarch laughs at your efforts. You are a renowned gladiator, he says, and have fought often in my pay. For these past services, I give you your life. But to prove your worthiness for freedom, you need to find an exit from the Demon's Forge. Guards, remove him. You reason that you may as well have been executed. The Demon's Forge, an infamous dungeon network, has an exit as well as an entrance, but no one in past centuries has escaped alive. You laugh bitterly, planning revenge as they cast you within, with nothing to aid you save a package of rations. Perhaps you will surprise them yet. The object of Demon's Forge, trademark, is to escape from the cave into which the king has banished you. In order to escape, you must solve a variety of puzzles and problems as you move through a maze of rooms and situations by letting the computer be your eyes, hands, and ears. The Demon's Forge is not an adventure easily solved. You may reach an impasse that will require great deliberation before an answer is apparent. In any case, if the obvious fails, reach for the obscure. Try to go every direction through every door, hole, and crevice. Do not assume anything is ordinary or any object useless, and by the same token, do not assume every object is crucial to the adventure's solution. And keep a detailed map of your progress, lest you become lost and disoriented and fall unknowingly into Anoracle's clutches. Whoever the hell that is. The Demon's Forge is played by typing. One-word instructions for movement. I'm going to be using arrow keys. We can go up, down as well. Get, take, which I assume is the same thing. Drop, inventory, look, save, load, help, quick save, quick load. You can enter articles such as the and multiple commands. Unfortunately, there's no abbreviation, so I need to type out look at this instead of X. You are at the entrance of the cave. Commands. I don't think this works. It should. But I don't think it does. I don't know how to X. Look at guards. I see nothing special. I don't think this. I'm just testing my environment here. We don't know how to L. Look, guards. See nothing special. Okay. I'm gonna make typos here and there because this keyboard is not the best. I like it because it's lit. It's a thermal take keyboard, but I've had keyboards that are a lot easier to type on than that. They say move it. Okay. Move it. Moving things around gets you nowhere. One more thing to try. Kill guards. They are too big and ugly to try that. Okay. Go that way, can't go that way. Well, enter. You're in the entryway. The costume is here. The costume? Yeah. There was a vial in the costume. Now the thing is, I can't even hit the up arrow to repeat commands and go backspace. I gotta type everything. Look at vial. I see nothing special. Hey, just a vial. Well, get all works at least. So now I can go I, and I have the costume, and a vial full of a liquid, and the pack of rations. Look in vial. Nothing special. Nothing special. Okay, we're not very descriptive. Look at room. It looks nice. Okay. You were in someone's sleeping quarters. There was an old chest in the corner. Chest. Okay, open chest. Look in chest. You are looking in the chest. The blanket is here. The pillow is here. Got all. Closed chest. I vaguely remember this stuff, guys. Look at it. pillow. Okay, nothing special. Sleep. Sorry, I like a waterbed. get in bed. It is too heavy for me. Oh, I thought I meant get bed. Try the old King's Quest 3 thing. Look under bed. No. Alright. Can't do anything with the bed. Put pillow on bed. I dropped the pillow. Okay, it doesn't understand the bed as an object I can place things on. Okay, can't. I don't know what else is to be done here, so let's... Vamoose. A skinny man goes running by. Well, I saw nothing. You are in an old musty armory. There is an empty weapons closet in the corner. Look. Closet. It is empty. Well, you did tell me that, but, I can't open that. What about this? I don't know how to look at a pennant. It feels very sad for you. Look. Okay, it does recognize it as a tapestry. Oh, here. Look. Well, yeah. Get. I was thinking about looking under the tapestry, but what if we just take it? It is too heavy for me. Look. It doesn't look that heavy. Look under. Do you understand? Remove. Remove. I don't know how to remove. Okay. You are in the alchemist's room. Look at room. It looks nice. Yeah, and it's interestingly enough, I have a mouse pointer here. I guess I'll just take that off because we didn't use a mouse in this game. There was no mouse back then. Pretty sure I played this on my, well, not my, but the family's Tandy 1000. So, yeah. It looks like a table. Okay. You are at the junction route. There's a statue of a bird head here. Oh, something about this bird head, isn't it? Paul. Who else? Paul. Well, I downloaded this from, I think, was it Home of the Underdogs? Or they redirected me somewhere else? That's right. Alright, This thing is dangerous in some way. There is something in his beak. At the beak. There's definitely something inside. You stick your hand in the beak and it snaps shut on your hand for eternity. That's a very long time. Yes. Load. Yes. I don't know what to do with the beak. No, it just drops it. Since when does putting something in something drop it? I don't know what to do with the beak. Skinny man didn't go running by this time. Okay. So the only way I have left to go is this way. You are in the Great Hall. I don't suppose, nope. Okay. Nothing special. Alright. You are at an old well that has some water in it. Hmm. It looks very deep and wet. Jump into the well and drown. Why am I not surprised? Why did I try it? No idea. To do about the well. Let's go. You are in the room of the burning brazier. And yes, it's not brazier. That's something that women wear. This is a brazier. Look at the brazier. It looks very hot. This game is just way too descriptive. I mean, just walls of text coming at us. I just can't read all this crap. It puts Pillars of Eternity to shame. I don't know what to do with it. Can we light something? What do we have? We have a costume. We have a liquid blanket pillow. Pack of rations. Light. Pillow. Throw vial on. Pretty sure. Drop the vial. No. I'm gonna drop it. Does it still have stuff in it? It looked kind of empty, didn't it? But that might be the color scheme. Did it have liquid in it before? When did it say it had liquid? I don't know. Burning brazier, I don't know what to do with this. You are in Anoracle's laboratory. There's an empty vat here. Look at the vat. It's empty. Too heavy, I bet. Yeah. What about this table? It looks like a table. Just like the other table, it looks like a table. Okay. What else? You stand before two huge oaken doors. Doors are locked from the other side. Probably this is what I could never get past. Locked from the other side. Hit doors. I don't know how to hit. Kick doors. An empty vat. Don't know how to pull. Well, with some water and brazier, what if we put out the fire? Something. Haven't tried this yet. Wear a costume. It's a good fit. How do I look with this costume? Look at me. I don't know how to look at a me. Open doors. Custom file. Blanket pillow. Okay, I'm not sure how far I got, but this is probably it. I couldn't figure it out. I just consulted a walkthrough. We can move this chest, first of all. A bag of ashes was behind the chest. Got the bag. Nothing special. Got the bag. Now, if we see this guy again. That's west. Z? We need him to come back. I don't know if he will come back. I wonder if anyone finished this game without getting some kind of assistance. He's not reappearing. Start all over again here. He must have gone through one of these two doors. Oh, I did not know which one to go through. You are in the skinny man's room. Well, he's a skinny man, and he likes the color pink. Oh, look. Oh, look at the man. The man. Oh, shh. No. No. Oh, I could. Okay. Nothing special. Talk to man. I'm skinny. I think this is what we're supposed to do. Give rations to man. Skinny man quickly snatches your food and downs it, and he returns you. In return, he gives you a rod. And look, rod. I see nothing special. I'm still skinny. I don't know what would have happened if I had gone through the other door. But anyway, now we have a rod. We know that move is a command now. Moving things around gets you nowhere. Well, except for the chest. Burn bag. A huge, insane fire elemental issues forth from the brazier and tortures you. The rod will not fit anywhere in this room. Okay. Most games don't accept the word use because you can just type use anything. I'm not completely sure where we're supposed to use this. Oh, right. Yes, I do remember. You insert the rod and the beak snaps shut on it. A red gem comes rolling out onto the ground. Look at the gem. You see nothing special, I bet. Yeah. Got it. I'm gonna save because I'm not completely sure what I'm doing as usual. I don't know how to use that. You throw the bag of ashes onto the brazier, and Joe, the fire elemental, comes to your aid. Okay, Joe, nothing special. Hey, nothing special, just your garden variety fire elemental. I mean, you see him every day, don't you? As soon as you and Joe approach the doors, they go up in flames. There's an assassin here, and I believe he's been waiting for you, and I believe there is some poison dripping off his arrow. Not sure. Okay. Ass in. The assassin shoots you in the side. This is when we drink vial. You don't have the vial. Ah! The poison on the arrow kills you. Kill is you. Not too good there. What's that quote doing? We don't have the vial. Oh. Because we have to look at the costume, then there's a vial, and then get all. Okay. Use gem. Do we have the gem? Yes. Burn. Bag. Show fire elemental. Try now. The assassin shoots you in the side. Drink. Vial. You have neutralized the poison. Again. Nice. You run over to the assassin and kill him. Command. Look at the assassin. His pocket looks full. Ooh. Look in. Pocket. I don't know how to look at a pocket. Open pocket? Pocky? Open. Pocket. I don't know how to open a pocket. What about his bow? Nothing special. Get bow. You can't have that. What? I don't know how to get a pocket. How we open? Alright, I'm looking. Search assassin. Game is really picky. This is not good text adventures. Good quality. You search a dead assassin and find a chime. Let me guess. Looking at the chime, we see nothing special. Get chime. Okay. Seems like we've accomplished something. Let's save. The assassin's room. You stand before two huge oaken doors. Well, what remains of them anyway? Now I'm not sure. We filled the vial with the water. Okay, now we can go down. Joe evaporates. Where do these people learn to write? Joe evaporates the water and vanishes. You are at the bottom of the well. It is slowly filling back up with water. Okay, not completely sure here. Open door. There is no handle on it. Know how to use that. Low chime? What's the command? Ring chime. My god. The door opens and you fall into the next room. The trick room. First left and then right until stop. That's a good time to save. Left and then right. Left. You have taken a wrong turn and will now wander the paths of infinity. Alright, and we'll play again. Load. First left. Left. Right, 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 until stop. I see stop. I see a sign here. I mean, look at stop. Nothing special. You could tell me it says stop, and you could at least do that. It looks nice. Okay. There is a rabbit here. You are in the magician's room. The wand is here. The hat is here. Get on. I can only carry 6 objects. What? Let's look at everything. Look at the wand. Great. Look at the hat. Great. Look at the rabbit. He looks a bit dehydrated. Oh. Give vial to rabbit. I don't know how to give that. Feed rabbit. Sorry, these are carnivorous bunnies. Well, I didn't specify what I was feeding him with. I could be feeding him my own fingers, for all we know. Let's... give water to rabbit. The rabbit takes the water and runs away. I hope that was something we were supposed to do. I can't even pick up any okay. Let's drop the chime. Get the wand. I've been advised that the hat is not doing anything. I just want to finish the game and show you guys what it's like. You're in a hallway facing east. There's a small grotto to the north. Am I supposed to go that way? There's a door of rubber here. I'm gonna save, it's been a while. Door. Nothing special. Okay, this is where we wave the wand. The wand emits a fiery ball which roars out and melts the door, unfortunately catching the rug on fire. We're supposed to use the blanket. Or blankie. That does the trick. The flames have been extinguished. Forward. You are in the smithy. The axe is here. Look at axe. You really don't want us to look at anything, do you? Get axe. I guess when we use the wand, it disappears. No, we still have it. A vial with only air in it. 1, 2, 3. Did I drop only one thing and I got 2 things? Oh no, that's right, blanket was used up. Fire. Okay. There's a splendid view of a forest here. There are mirrors all around. Okay. Now we want to break the mirrors. The blow of the axe has shattered the mirror in 100 shards. Now apparently we have to drop some stuff. You're in the guard room. You're in a small garden. There was a carrot down there. Is that where we're supposed to be getting? Yeah. Okay. Got the carrot. You're in the guard's sleeping quarters. Climb. The pendant is here. Well, I think we have to look at it, read it. Have the pendant. Okay, get the pendant. Pendant. There's some writing on it. Read pendant. The pendant reads, dig where X's are and are not. We want the boots too, but we don't want to put them on yet. Can only carry 6 objects. What else are we supposed to be dropping? Well, I think if we wear the costume, then we can get the boots. Supposedly we're still carrying it somehow. So what do we want to drop? Wand, costume, vial with air, pillow, carrot, or pendant. I think we can drop the vial. If not, well, remember it's here. Because we need the boots, apparently. Four-way intersection. You are in the robing room. Mm. Oh, what does the pendant say? Dig where X's are. Ah. All four staves are here. The first staff is glowing. Look at first staff. I see nothing special. Get first staff. As you pull the first staff from the wall, it turns into a shovel. There's a wooden door on the ground here. Open door. Am I going down? That makes sense. The intersection of the elements. There's an ore hopper here. There's a torch burning on the wall. Okay, we don't want to mess with that yet. There's an old fountain here with some water at the bottom. The bottle is here. Try to climb something. E.g. wall. Alright, climb wall. Alright. Now, I think I'm supposed to do something here, actually. First two. You float to the roof. This is pretty obscure. Dig the roof. You dig the roof and a mound of dirt falls to the ground. The boots stop working and you drop. Boots. Get dirt. I got the mound. Now we can do this. Put dirt in the hopper. You fill the hopper with the dirt and are transported back to the staff room. Only three staves remain. The second staff is now glowing. Does this make any sense at all, guys, to you? You pull the second staff from the wall. This bottle we want. Bottle. Right, we got the bottle. Yeah. Makes a lot of sense. Breathe water. You fill the bottle with your breath. Burn second staff. The staff burns and you are transported back to the staff room. Only two more staves hang on the wall. The third staff is now glowing bright. Weird. Well, it kind of makes sense in a weird way because you've got earth, fire. Here's the water. Second? Okay. Pull the third staff from the wall. Down, and then where's this thing? In the classroom. The water in the fountain clears, and there was something written there. Read. Fountain. At the bottom of the fountain it reads, "To avoid eternal strife, you must give the breath of life. Do this deed first, pay nothing else heed. Or these words may be the last that you read." You are transported back to the staff room. Only one staff is still here. Only one staff is still here. This fourth staff is very bright now. Get fourth staff. You grab the last staff and the statue animates to life and demands that you drop the last staff before leaving. There's only one staff. Can I just refer to this as staff? The fourth staff vanishes and you are free to go. Supposedly we can drop the bottle as well, and then head to the right. There was a drop-off ahead. Let's save, it's been a while. Let's do a new one. You plunge off the drop-off and break your back. Would you like to play again? Yes. Drop pillow. I think we want throw pillow off. Drop off. The pillow drops off the edge and lands. The pillow softens the landing. You are in the ice room. Pillow is here. Okay, supposedly this is what we're supposed to do, is go left. You are facing west, looking over an evil bridge. Well, I'm not completely sure, but we're supposed to drop all. And then left. You are in the room of the spheres. The gold sphere is here, platinum sphere is here, silver sphere is here. We're all here. Okay, get all. We got him. Supposed to be die otherwise. If we don't do this. You are a good juggler. Supposedly we need the carrot though. You are in the torture chamber. See no altar here. Well, that's not where we're supposed to do that then. The Chamber of Pillars. River running through the room. The river runs through it. Where's this altar? Ah. Yeah, I'm totally just following a walkthrough. I just want to see how this ends. There's a passage behind the altar. You're in the antechamber room. For some reason, why we want to close the door and then go forward. You are standing in the prisoner's jail. The key is here. Okay. I don't know how that happens. Looking out a ledge, you can see a sign in the distance. Now this is actually pretty funny. Your eyes are not good enough to see that far. We eat the carrot. You see much better. Wow, that works quickly. The sign reads, "Within the forge, an oracle goes to test the metal of his foes, to pit his claws against cold steel, spin wise the globes into a wheel of sword and spear. They harmeth not, nor ageless cold or timeless rot, but balls of value shirk his hold when hurled with power, slight to bold." So we'll see what happens. Swim. We get here, we want to throw the key for some reason. You throw the key across the river. And then swim. Aha! You're an ancient crypt, the key is here. Get key. I'm not sure, I guess we lose the key otherwise? Is locked. Unlock door. The door is now unlocked. Open door. And now I believe we dropped the key. What? I'm so scared, guys. You're face to face with Anoracle himself. It looks like he's weaving a spell. My god, the jump scares in this game. Just insane. Remember what it said. Throw silver... sphere. The silver spear strikes the demon's hide and explodes. Well, that's when you want the quote there. Between the demon and the ass. Gold sphere hits the demon and he screams out in agony. I don't know if just viewing the inventory could kill you itself. I don't even know if that counts as a move. I don't know if we're counting moves. The platinum sphere hits the demon and destroys him in a blinding flash. The demon's throne slides aside, revealing with a random capitalized letter, revealing a dim cavern that winds its way to the surface. You step into the bright sunlight and are immediately arrested by guards. They bring you before the king, who returns your original weapons and clothing. Well done, champion. Where am I? By returning from the demon's forge, you have regained your freedom. No, would not like to play again. Okay, the thing just quit out on me completely. The window closed. I didn't think that would happen. The funny thing about this game, I forgot to say, is that one side of the floppy disk was for IBM compatibles and Tandy, and the other side was for Commodore 64, I believe, which is very odd. I did not know that was possible because at that point, you know, even though I was a teenager and we were still talking about, well, late 80s at that time, I knew that, you know, they were incompatible. Although discs would be the same size, you couldn't read, so I suppose they found a way and formatted one side to IBM specifications and the other side to Commodore. So, it was pretty interesting. Well, thanks for watching. This is my little IBM foray, and, you know, all the other games that I would play, that I have played back then, are, you know, a little too long for this, you know, let's revisit series. So, yeah, I just wanted to play this relatively short game and show you guys the wonders of CGA and EGA graphics. Ooh, weren't they so pretty? We've sure come a long way in graphics. So thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Amiga, next time for sure. Endure, in enduring, grow strong.